Hello guys and welcome. Today we are going to build a big farmhouse for this beautiful llama and also for some other animals. Because I'm about to get a horse soon and we're also going to get some sheep because I keep running out of wool and I don't want to shear wild sheep anymore. I want to actually have a big farm. So we're going to build a farmhouse here, but first of all we need to create a foundation, a layout of this house, like how big it will be and everything. Like, it's so important when you want to have, like, especially like bigger structures, to have a good foundation, a good layout, so you already know the shape of the building, how large it will be, and from there you can also plan how many doors this will have, if this will have a double door, a single door, how big the windows will be, how many floors. So yeah, the layout of the structure, like the foundation, is the most important part when it comes to building. And this is gonna be a huge house. There will be multiple beds in it. There will be multiple crafting stations, most likely some cauldrons. And yeah, as you guys can see, this will be very spacious. It will have at least 2 floors. There will be some sort of small garden here and also a balcony. I plan to actually add a balcony. It will probably be a double roof house, so I'm gonna have like a double roof here, and not too sure if I should make it maybe bigger, but no, I think that's actually big enough. Yeah, let's go with that. So now it's time to maybe I bring it out later by another block, but yeah, now it's time to add the floor. I think it's big enough. I decided to use a mixture of spruce wood and also some oak wood. Like, the furniture and the floor will most likely be oak and the walls will be spruce. Oh wow, this is so freaking spacious. I'm wondering how many beds I can actually fit in there. I actually have double roofs. Maybe I should bring it out more. Okay, so somewhere over here will be the door, and that's why I said earlier it's so important to have the right layout, so you know which door is where. If you have like single windows, double windows on this and that side. So yeah, here would be a second entrance, and there would be like a small kind of garden, and then the farm will start. So yeah, let's work on the wall now. So here would be somewhere a pillar, so it's realistic. So this is for stabilizing the little balcony that I will add here. There will be a balcony on top of that entrance. The entrance will be here. And somewhere over there will be the wall. And I will work with spruce wood for the wall. I hope it's not gonna be too dark, but in my experience it still should look nice in lighter biomes like the plains. Okay guys, so the foundation is done. We have the wall now, and how big it is, I actually extended it by another block, that's why it's a bit bigger than before. And as you guys can see, this will be a very spacious farmhouse. And oh wow, I already have some ideas with what kind of furniture I put in. And yeah, here will be a single window. Here will be probably 2 double windows or 1 double window. Not sure, maybe I'll go actually with 1 double window. On this side will be 2 double windows. I mean, I could make a triple window as well, like, let's see, but maybe it's too big. Here will be a single window, I guess. There will be a double window behind, and here we're gonna have a door. For the door, I would probably use dark oak, because I really love the look of the dark oak doors. And yeah, I will strip this wood. I actually feel like spruce wood, like the stripped logs, they look so nice, right? For that, right now, I'm using a stone axe, and I will later explain you something, because it actually doesn't matter if you're using a stone axe or iron axe or even wooden axe, because it doesn't really change the speed on how fast you strip them, right? You can save something, so yeah. Let me guys show you how I usually start my buildings when it also comes to like doors and windows. So I usually do the windows first before I do the wall. Like, I've seen some people, they just place a wall and then once it's done they just cut out everything that they want to be cut out. But for me, I make windows before I make the rest, so I know where stuff is gonna be. Then I can always improvise in case I want it to be a bit bigger, or well, I find it like not so symmetrical. But yeah, here we're gonna have 2 double windows. It's spacious enough. 10. Oh, wow. Like, I don't like, I've seen some people and they make like windows with like 4 glass planes and like those super, super huge windows, but I find them too unrealistic. Because if you get an apartment somewhere in real life, you also don't have like super huge windows, right? And yeah, what I said earlier about the stone axe and the iron axe, I would, if you can, use stone axes instead of iron axes, because I kept wasting a lot of iron in the past, and only when it comes to cutting, they have a different piece, but not when it comes to stripping those logs, right? And you can easily recraft stone axes at all times. Okay, yeah, so we've almost finished the first floor. And as you guys can see, it turned out pretty well. It's very spacious and I like spacious buildings. I think it's actually better to have fewer buildings but bigger buildings than to have many small buildings. In some of the previous Kingdom projects, I would often build like a lot of small houses. But I came to realize that I can actually have a way higher population with many bigger houses, but I can also make those buildings look more special, like this one right there. Just look at it. It looks so nice from indoors as well, right? Like, we can add so much furniture and decoration here, multiple working stations, and we're also gonna add some stairs here, and this will lead upstairs. The stairs will also make a turn at some point. Let me show you how I turn stairs. So yeah, let's work on those stairs. It will lead up here. I decided to go with oak for the stairs and the ground because I think it matches pretty well with the spruce. It doesn't look too bad, right? And yeah, somewhere over there will be a turn. So yeah, let's bring this up. Now here I want a turn. Yeah, I think that is perfect. So yeah, let's put stairs here. As you guys can see, we have now a turn. I think stairs look better this way than if you just make them lead straight up. If you want to have like a good look, try to make your buildings look a bit abstract. Let's get some more oak. And let's finish the roof. Because the first floor is almost done. Okay, some torches because I don't want stuff to spawn. Like, imagine a creeper just spawns while I'm building. That would be so annoying, right? And then it blows up this beautiful house. So yeah, let's finish this floor. Oh wow, I'm actually quite impressed. I like this layout. Okay, we are done now with the first floor. Let's work on the second one here. And as you guys can see, that turn is actually pretty nice. Like when you go upstairs, how you're making a turn. Let's finish that wall. I'll probably add the same kind of windows on this floor than downstairs, so it looks somewhat symmetrical, right? Only this side, I'll probably have, yeah, I'll have here a double window. There would be probably no window. Here would be a small balcony. And oh wow, that view is so great from here, right? Like we couldn't really see like the whole farm from here. Wow. Okay, now this one is done too, and as you guys can see, it's really nice. Even that door, it looks really, really great, right? Like the dark oak door with the spruce, and it's just so nice. There's the entrance to the garden, the farm, and we already have a balcony here. It's a really nice house, right? Like, try to do this if you can, guys. Like, try to find ways to add balconies, add different floors, maybe have like multiple roofs. This will look so nice at the end. Like, it's better to invest more time into a building than to do everything just super quick, right? Like, look at the view. Oh wow, it's so pretty. But too bad that there will be a wall in the future, so we won't have that view, but we will see the other side. Like, we're still gonna have a view at the farm, just not at this side. But okay, let's finish the roof. I decided to work with a mixture of dark oak stairs with regular spruce stairs. Like, I love that nice change when it comes to color with the roof. I think that looks pretty decent, right? Like, look at that color change right there. That's so nice. I'm quite satisfied with that look. Oh wow, and a great view from here. You can see that small castle. Turned out pretty well. You guys see the roof is done now. So yeah, this one has a double roof and it turned out pretty well, even like indoors. It's so spacious, right? I'll probably go with like red carpet because I already put there some red beds. And I feel like red really matches here. And look at that roof. It turned out pretty well, right? Now if you go outside, this balcony is just so great. And from here we can see the farm later on. Like this side we can forget because there will be probably a big wall. So this we can't see anymore, but we will still be able to see the farm. Let's start placing some windows in and then we're gonna add some window shutters from the outside and we're gonna decorate the outside and then further work on the inside. And oh wow. Like what I often do is like when I have like crazy ideas about builds, I will sometimes just take a pencil and write something down. And I kind of like had a similar idea with this house. Like one day while I was playing Minecraft, I realized, hey, you know what? Add a nice farmhouse to your Plains Kingdom. And here we are building something incredible, right? Now let's add some red carpet because I think red will really look well and have a nice contrast with the spruce color. Like in my experience, red looks really nice with spruce. It's the same with cherry, right? Like cherry wood is a bit darker, right? And cherries are red. So here we're gonna have some contrast like that as well. Oh wow, I can already see that. It actually looks really nice. Was the right choice to work with red here. Blue would look also somewhat okay, but I think red and purple. Like yeah, red and purple goes really well with spruce. Okay, let's add some seats now. I think we'll start downstairs. Maybe at this side. Let's see. Okay, I will place this here. And then here. For now, I will go with oak, but maybe in the future, I will use dark oak or even spruce for the seat. Because I just realized it has like the same color as the ground almost. But let's just place them for now as placeholders so I know where the seats will be. And I'll probably change this later on. Oh yeah, I ran out of those, so let's get some more. Maybe it would actually look nice once I add like some carpet as a table. I mean, I could use like a trapdoor as well, or even like pressure plates, but yeah, I think here would be just two seating areas. Maybe there would be one upstairs. Let's see. And what I usually use for the table is I will use like a fence, and then what I do once I have that fence and place it there, I will either put a pressure plate on top or a carpet. But I personally prefer carpets because this looks like there's actually tablecloth on top of that table. So yeah, let's store some of the things. Okay, time to work on the outside. So let's add some dark oak stairs there as protection. I'm gonna add some window shutters on the side. I love those spruce window shutters. I think they are the best for window shutters from all of them in my opinion. But then again, on some builds, even dark oak trapdoors can look nice for window shutters. Since we are on survival, I will use now some dirt to get up there and also add there some window shutters. I'll probably also add some flower pots under the window, but hey, let's see. Let's for now just use the window shutters and the stairs and see how it turns out. I think maybe that would look nice if I add some flower pots there. But I will only do this upstairs because for downstairs I have a little surprise for you guys later on. And yeah, that actually looks so much better. Yeah, let's get some flowers. I want to try this and see how flower pots will look like at the window. Let's get also some azure flowers here. Blue ones. And I can already tell the difference. This house looked so boring before we added those window shutters, but now it starts to take on some form, some shape. Let's see. I'll go here with the azure bluettes. I hope I pronounced them correct. Sorry if I don't. Okay, how do we reach there? Let's use some dirt. Nice. Oh well. I can already see that this looks actually really nice. This is a great idea to add that. Oh wow. Quite satisfied. But stuff just takes so much longer if you're building in survival, but I hate using creative mode. It feels like cheating to me. Like, I don't like to build in creative. I prefer in survival. And okay, this is done and I like that actually. Okay, just look at that, like wow. I've added now everywhere like those flower pots, window shutters and those dark oak stairs, and it looks really nice, this house. Like, this looks like a real farmhouse now. Just look at that. And that double roof looks nice, especially that it makes some kind of turn and goes in a bit on one side. Now let me show you something really cool. So I'm going to place now some bushes there. And how do you get those bushes? You're basically using shears and you're shearing oak trees. This looks also really great. I'll probably place this almost all around the whole house. Okay, I messed up here. So yeah, if you use shears on leaf blocks, you can retrieve them. Oh, nice. That looks more natural. Then again, this is supposed to be a farm, and a farm is close to nature. We have animals and stuff, and they're actually farmers living that farm things. And what's actually funny is I don't live too far from a farm. I live in a small town in Germany, and if I walk for like 20 minutes, I'm already at a farm. Because I live at the border of this town, so... Oh, wow. Could have also used the jungle ones. That would have also looked nice. Or birch. Birch is actually darker, but I think I actually like the dark oak leaf blocks. Especially the entrance looks so nice now. It's like we walk between the bushes to enter the house. And for the inside area, I thought about something really cool. I'm gonna work with some oak trapdoors, and I will use them as holders for flower pots. You could also put there some hay bales or some maybe barrels or bookshelves, but I will go for flower pots this time. And yeah, let's start placing those in. I already collected a bunch of flowers, and we also have some bamboo. I'm also gonna place some bamboo in here. I thought about using some cactuses, but I don't think cactuses would fit in here, right? That's a bit unrealistic, because we are in medieval times here, so... What you also can do is you can actually use also oak saplings. They look also really nice for indoor plants. And look at that bamboo. Oh, wow. That looks so great. This is a great idea to work with that. And I love the contrast between the oak and the spruce. I think it's really nice to use that on... The same is if you use, like, for example, if I would have used like stripped oak logs, would also look nice. And I changed, by the way, the table, as you guys can see, the seats with spruce. And oh wow, it turned out pretty well. How does it look from here? Oh wow, here would be the big farm. And maybe I should add a bench here or something, right? You know what? Let's add a bench. I think it would be nice so the people that live there can relax there at the bench. Let me show you a trick on how you guys can create a bench. Should I add another one? No, let's go with one. So yeah, if you're using signs... Okay, I don't have enough wood. Let's get some more planks. If you're using actually signs, you can make some nice arm holders for a bench. Let me demonstrate it in a moment. Probably most of you have already used this, but if you didn't know this, you can actually place signs in two stairs. And that way you can create some sort of arm holders, right? And now this looks like a real bench. Like, if you look at it, like, look at this. This looks so comfortable now. We're also going to add some trapdoors on top, and there would be either hay bales or maybe some barrels or something. I don't think I will add flower pots there, but hey, let's see. I'll figure something out for here. That looks great. Oh, wow. Now, what you also need to do, because it's a bit shady here, I need to add some light here. A torch, so stuff doesn't spawn. And that's a nice second entrance here. There's so much work that still needs to be done for the indoors area, but pretty satisfied with the house. Let's have a look from far how it looks. And oh wow, this turned out pretty well. It looks like a real farmer house now. It was good to use stripped logs. Like, the cool thing about spruce is you have those giant spruce trees, so you can get a lot of logs. And oh wow, time to make the farm now for the llama. You will have a home in a moment. You will have a very big, nice farm, and I will catch some more llamas for you, new friends. Okay, let's place the fence somewhere here. I'll probably make this either 9 or 10 blocks wide. I'll probably go with 10 blocks. Now here will be the fence gate. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. You have the right coordinates. It's quite symmetrical. Oh, nice. Soon we can watch all those animals from the window. Maybe I will turn this into my main home. Just because it's so idyllic and peaceful here. I love it. Okay, now it's done. Let me show you a little trick how to make the gate look more interesting. The entrance. I've learned a little trick. I was actually inspired by the naturally spawned generated savannah villages. If you use actually some fence on fence, you can actually create a really nice ranch-like entrance here. And we're also gonna place here a sign, and we will name this. We will name this something. What should we name it? Home for llamas. Yeah, home for llamas. This will be the name. Okay, that's funny. Home for llamas. Now we just need to get multiple llamas later on. For now, we have at least one llama, right? But there's a mountains biome nearby, so I can grab some more llamas from there. Let's remove that so we can have later on a good look at this. And time to move you, my little friend. You get into your new farm. Follow me. You have a new beautiful home. With a new beautiful house next to it. There we go. Your new home. Sorry about the high grass. Maybe you can eat it or something. Oh wow. It's quite spacious. I can fit here like 7-8 llamas. And just look at that with the background. That's a nice house. I especially like that balcony a lot and the double roof. It turned out pretty well, right? Same with the bushes there. But anyway, guys. That's it for today's episode. I hope you guys enjoyed this one. There will be a part 2. I will further decorate it and extend the farms with more animals. And yeah, if you haven't subscribed already, please consider subscribing. That would really mean a lot. And don't forget to like this video and hit the notification bell so you don't miss out on any new videos. I wish everyone a wonderful day. Please stay all safe and healthy. And I will see you guys soon again. Have a wonderful day. Until next time.